And now, the 2000 team induction and from hockey, the 1945-46 Winnipeg Monarchs, winners of the Memorial Cup. They were big names in South Winnipeg. Most of them had attended Kelvin High School. But they weren't known nationally until the 1945-46 Winnipeg Monarchs stepped onto the ice at Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto. The Monarchs were products of a number of community club teams. Forwards Don Red McRae, Clint Albright, and Beatty played their minor hockey at Sir John Franklin. Gordon Scott and Captain Al Buchanan, both forwards, and defenseman Cam Miller and Doug Daniels were from Lord Roberts. Goalkeeper Jack Gibson, defenseman Tom Rocky, and forward Harry Taylor played in St. James. Defensive stars Laurie May and Bill Tindall played for the Excelsiors. Spare goalie Ted Chitley and forward Eddie Marchant were from the West End Orioles. Tank Comerfield played at Weston. Gordy Fashaway started in Transcona. And speedy George Robertson from West Kildonan didn't play organized hockey at all until he joined the Juvenile Monarchs. Walter Monson, who had played for Canada's 32 Olympic champs, coached the club. Pat Lyon was the GM, and Ed Haverstock was the trainer. When people evaluate a boxer, it's not so much who he was, but who did he beat? This was the case with the Monarchs. There were a lot of opposition players down the rocky road that led to the Memorial Cup who became NHL stars, but the Monarchs managed to vanquish them all. In the league, they had to get by the Winnipeg Rangers, who had a pretty good goaltender by the name of Terry Sajak. And there wasn't much talk of Memorial Cup when they began by losing their first playoff game 12-3 to Brandon, who were led by Don Rawley, Wally Hergesheimer, and Bing Jukes, who were called up for five AHL games that season. But the Monarchs defeated Brandon in five games. They went on to eliminate the Port Arthur Flyers in five games, and that set up the Memorial Cup final with the Toronto St. Mikes. The St. Mikes had on paper one of the best junior squads ever assembled. Playing for the Double Blue were the likes of Red Kelly, Todd Sloan, Fleming McKell, Ed Sanford, Eddie Harris, and Les Costello. Following Game 1, which the Monarchs took 3-2, St. Mike's displayed their power, winning the next two games 5-3 and 7-3. With two goals and an assist from Taylor, the Monarchs came back to win the next game 4-3 to even up the series. Then it was the smooth-talking Sloan's turn to turn star. He had five goals in a 7-4 Toronto victory. The Monarchs rallied to win Game 6 4-2, and that forced a seventh and deciding game. There were 15,000 fans watching that final game, more than had ever attended a Maple Leafs contest. The capacity at the Gardens was 12,627, and after two periods of play, the teams were deadlocked at 2-2. George Robertson scored twice in the third period, including an insurance goal when they had just announced the last minute of play, capping a Cinderella season with a 4-2 Winnipeg Monarchs victory. Sloan scored 11 goals in the series for St. Mike's, while Taylor had 5 goals and 8 assists. Robertson, 6 goals and 4 assists, and McRae, 4 and 5 for the Monarchs. The 1945-46 Winnipeg Monarchs, Memorial Cup champions, and now members of the Manitoba Sports Hall of Fame.